So here is a parallel extension cable, or it was. The other end is over there. There are pins on that one. So anyway, this is the one that actually connects to the printer. That side, these so-called Centronics 36-pin connector, and this. This would go to the parallel port, the socket on a computer. So there are pins on there. And so, basically, I want to make a kind of interface using an Arduino so that I can just connect this to a port on my own interface, basically. And so this is going to be it. This is a socket, after all. So I've cut that off, stripped each of these wires, which look very nice. All of the colours, if I get you into a light place, you can see the nice colours. But unfortunately that doesn't actually tell me which pins they're connected to. It seems to be some proprietary colouring scheme. So that's why I've stuck a wire in there. That's pin 2. I'm going to be touching my multimeter between that and each one of these until I finally get some focus and a connection. I'm going to stick these in a nice fan shape kind of thing, like that, on a piece of cardboard, and labelling each of them. And then I can actually start soldering proper wires to them, and they're going to go to these several extension leads, and the several extension leads are going to go to the Arduino, and then the Arduino is going to encode, it's going to make it communicate with the laptop, and fun stuff is going to happen. And there we go. Imagine why they look kind of neat. I'll be using these, and then also our strobe, of course. That is just pulsed once you've set all of these to indicate that you've set them, then it's time to read a new byte from them. The arrow shows the direction, the PU meaning the printer, so this is coming out of the printer, and this is going into the printer, and these can be used either way. So I'll just be looking out for busy and error and paper out. And yes, there we go basically. One night of tapping a voltmeter and some things, sticking a piece of wire into those holes. Yes. Well, here we are, stuff is being connected. I just decided to connect them all mainly because it would look cool. And then we have these going to here, which is port A on the Arduino Maker, and this is port C if I'm right. 22, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So then alternating between left and right is port A. It's connected, so the bits on the Arduino correspond to the bits on the parallel port. And then also I've connected busy, paper out, and error, and ground, and strobe. So, and these are connected so that you can just read individual bits of port C, so you don't have to do digital read, which is really slow. Well, things have moved on a bit. There are now LEDs here, and on the back, some, yes, morning bars, and also resistors and LEDs and wires and hot glue and solder. So now, if I were to join these together, by the way, the Arduino is not actually plugged in. If I do plug this in, which is, this is going to the printer, then there are now some LEDs on here. These are being powered solely by the printer. And unfortunately, the Arduino is stealing some power for itself. And so I'm slowly going to plug this in a little bit so that the Arduino is being powered by the laptop. And these LEDs can then be properly bright. You should notice a difference around now. There we go. So you can see it's not actually far enough to be doing anything. So what's lit up? It is paper out, because the paper is out. And busy, for some reason, which is meant to be active low, and yet it's on, as if to say that it's not busy, as if to say that it's ready, in other words, which is a bit strange. Maybe this is actually active high, not sure. And strobe here is on, because it's active low. In other words, nothing's happening. So basically this will act like a communication LED and flicker as this is sending data to the printer. So, in other words, wait, is that right? No, it must be. Interesting. I guess the printer is pulling it high, and then we pull it to ground with this. It's working out as I go along, to be honest. Anyway, and so yeah, this will turn off every time a byte is sent. Now, let's put paper in here. I'm just going to drop it in and put that down there. See, paper out has turned off. And now error is on for some reason. You may have also noticed that it printed a character. That is not supposed to happen at all. That's because these are set to inputs still, and they're floating, and it's picking up some garbage data along these lines. Let's see what it printed this time, because last time it was a strange, like, bottom right square thing. I can't really see because it's printing over something. I'm not sure. Something on top of the at sign, which my camera is not wanting to focus on. Looks like a square root to me. So anyway, I just knocked this out a bit so everything's dark. Right, that's better. Interesting sound coming from upstairs. Anyway, I'm wondering if this is also meant to be active high, as in there's not an error now. And if I make it roll out the paper, so hold this down. We'll go back to paper out and busy. So, I'm wondering if I actually wrote these wrongly. This may be active low and this may be active high. Well, in any case, I'm going to now make a little sketch for this Arduino and get it to send some bytes to here. Which will go down the cable to the printer and hopefully end up on the paper, if you like. Test to print M's in a row. What is this? If I roll the paper out, then this happens. Tries to roll the paper in. And then it stops sending data. As you can see, because the strobe LED stops flashing. And I reload the paper. Should start again.